Hello everyone, welcome back to The Binding of Isaac After Birth. That continue there is because James and I were playing recently, and do you know what? Let's continue the Eden run. James is not here anymore, but I don't want to spend my Eden token, and we don't really play Eden all that often. Good grief, what have we got here? We've got the Polaroid already, which is great. 2 HP, the D8 could be interesting. We'll see what our stats are like. We have Pulseworm, and Pulseworm can be somewhat disorientating because it makes you feel like your damage is better than it is, because well, sometimes your shots are really big and that's not actually increasing your damage. This is a very, very low DPS start, it feels like. Let's have a look. I mean, it looks like our rate of fire and shot speed should be pretty good. Our own speed is apparently quite good, but we really need to at least try and get rid of some of these spawners, because otherwise we're going to be here all day trying to counter the vast number of creatures that are appearing on the screen. I don't know if this meters itself in some way such that... Will you please be aggroed over here so that I can kill you? I don't know if this meters itself in some way such that it doesn't completely fill the screen with impossible enemies, but, you know, possible quantities of enemies, I should say. I'm quite tempted to D8 right now. Let's see what we get. Our shot speed has gone way up. I can feel that right now. I don't feel like our DPS has actually improved at all, which is kind of what I was hoping to achieve. Wow, I'm surprised we killed that thing, because I didn't think I'd done any damage to it so far. In fact, I feel like our DPS has gone down because our rate of fire seems to have gone down. But I don't feel like our damage has gone up. It may have done so, however. So if we can just keep throwing these shots in here and dealing damage, we should deal damage to this unit, because this unit will not regenerate. We are going to be in this room for quite some time, so hold on to your hats. There we go. And then we can start thinking about this one. As long as it, you know, manages to... As long as we can get it down to each progressive next stage without it actually just regenerating between our shots, because our fire rate is so low that it's actually looking like it's unlikely. There we go. You can see that it does regenerate slightly between shots, which just shows how poor our DPS is. Please be a battery. There is a battery. We'll reroll a second time. It's super fast right now. That seems better. We've got a question mark. It's Lil Loki. Lil Loki actually could be a decent DPS upgrade for us. We've already spent 2.5 minutes on this floor, which is more than in some cases I would like to spend on the whole floor. But I feel like we've at least improved ourselves somewhat, even if we now have a pretty poor actual damage stat. I have to be honest, I prefer a rate of fire to good damage to some extent. Obviously, things like soy milk take that to a ridiculous extreme. Even then, soy milk is not actually that bad an item. I quite like it. It's just that it can really, really ruin a run that's basically already ruined. It's not going to improve a run, that's for sure. But it will make a run more interesting. And there are some situations in which soy milk can be a good item to take. I'm trying to think of them. Especially if you've got reasonably high damage already and you've got maybe piercing shots or something. But there are a considerably larger number of situations in which you don't want to take soy milk. Which challenges my original premise. I don't think I need that. My original premise that I prefer to have a rate of fire over damage, which is largely true, but not wholly true. Especially early on, being able to take out things like fires or to actually consistently destroy those nubs that do spiders. Much more important than, you know, being able to do one big shot every so often. I'm reasonably sure these nubs are actually DPS based, so you can do a lot of damage and take off several layers at once. You can see our DPS is still poor. None of our D8 plays so far have actually... Ow. I did not think you would jump this far, if I'm being honest. None of our D8 plays so far have really given us a major advantage, but at least it's got us out of the original doldrums, because you can see here, it's still not that great. But we've got little Loki helping out as well, which is actually making a big difference. Pageant Boy is no use, really. I will keep my key. I was umming and ahhing about whether to try and open that golden chest, but with the bomb and a key and the possible outcomes, not that exciting. Although we do have permanent Polaroid invincibility already. Okay, which is useful because I was so scared about being shot by this one that does a full heart of damage that I forgot to dodge the one that can do half heart of damage. This is awkward. Oh my god, please die. There we go. We do have enough HP, enough DPS to deal with that. And there are more, of course. So many champions right now. That did give us a spirit heart, so we are possibly okay. We just need to not die here. Not die has been achieved. We will take the HP. We'll take the spirit heart. We have been hit. More by my bad play than anything else. I've not really played Isaac for a while. Not that that's supposed to be any sort of excuse. Well, I suppose it is, or I wouldn't mention it. I guess I'm a little bit rusty. Yesterday I played with James, and it was entertaining to play with someone who'd never played before in co-op mode, but then James made me play Gungeon in co-op mode, so, you know, bit of give and take. I do feel like I've slightly forgotten how to correctly deal with many situations, and that was one of them. Don't seem to have the instincts. I know it's only the basement, and I managed to take red heart damage on the basement just before we picked up a spirit heart. Life goes on. We haven't actually completely lost our deal with the devil chance yet, so do not despair. And I think I'm not going to D8, by the way, in case you were wondering. We've re-rolled our stats twice now. Once thanks to a battery which drops straight away after we almost ruin the run with the first of the two. I don't think our stats are bad enough at this stage that we need to worry about re-rolling them. And honestly, I don't think Pulseworm is doing much for us, so... Ooh, that's very nice. That was a strange noise. It's on camera. It's on record. I can't take that back. Thank you, little Loki, for arresting the progress of that fly just now. If we can get some sort of damage upgrade or tears upgrade, I will be happy. Pulseworm is a candidate for replacement if we can find something. Although I didn't replace it with the battery. Yes, we will absolutely take Infestation 2. And our game will be much easier as a result. Still tempted to hit the D8. Please. I want bombs. Let's go into the shop. We have plenty of money. Sackhead is ideal. We saw this on the last episode with James, and James said, does that do more sacks? Yes, it does. We don't have any money left, but we should take two of spades and keep Perthrow. We didn't need to do that because we could still use the Perthrow on this floor and keep two of spades for better. But it's a minor mistake at an early stage of the game. How did I not get hit there? Little Loki is actually really helpful this early on because... really helpful. Quite helpful, simply because my DPS right now is kind of poor. That is a very useful place to have a secret room. I will keep the other bomb. I was really considering using it to get one of these chests, but we only have two keys, and that one doesn't stand to pay out too well, so I'm going to err on the side of it sucks, and maybe go for this chest because I'm tempted. I'm expecting a secret room here. So we will go for this, even though we've only got one bomb. There is a secret room. And of course, Sackhead will make it way better to have... way easier to have more bombs. We've got a Perthrow rune for... Ooh, a guppy item. I think we'll use it once. If we do get a deal with the devil, we'll still be able to buy it. Maybe I should just keep it. I don't really need the D8. Actually, that seems like a great idea. We should do that. Maybe we re-roll our stats one more time, or several more times, now that we've got all these batteries, thanks to Sackhead. We had it yesterday, or on the previous run with James. It does give you more sacks, that's correct. But it's a very, very useful item early on, especially in dailies, which this is not. Ah, of course, we're not playing the deal with the devil. Thank you for reminding me, just before I actually screwed that one up, we're not taking deals with the devil. We are, in fact, trying to see whether the self-sacrifice runes give you a better chance of deals with the angel. They do give you angel items if you play them for long enough, but I don't think we can. Since we're not going to be spending our HP on devil deals, I'm very tempted to turn my other HP, or all my HP, into spirit hearts just to see what happens. Mostly because then we are guaranteed never to take red heart damage again. Range upgrade is okay. Let's see what we get. Apparently, our whatever the arrow is, probably our shot speed is going up crazily. I'd like a bit more speed. That's a bit more speed. Pressing tab as though that's the thing that you get. Oh, goodness. That's our rate of fire now. No. Next. That seems okay. But nice. It was speedy enough. I'm going to keep this one. Oh, here's what we do. Go throw that. Oh, that's terrible. We got a guppy item anyway. We got a judgment card for some reason. 10 minutes onto the next floor, but we're making progress. Steady progress. We're not going to make boss rush. Of that, I'm sure. Of this, I'm sure. I have not replaced my red heart with 3 spirit hearts like I said it would. It was an idle threat, really. No, it's just some musing in the moment. I wasn't necessarily going to do it, and I haven't done it. The reason is, I mean, we can do it in emergency at some point. But I don't think it's that big a deal to do it at all. No secret room there, I guess. Bad trip. That's no good. So in an emergency, we could replace our red heart with 3 spirit hearts. But why did I think it was that way? I thought I was in the other room, that's why. I'm going to keep hold of it for now. Oh, we could sell it somewhere. We could use it for some good, basically, is what I'm thinking. Maybe a blood bank or something. There's no need to sell the HP, unless we're in dire straits, in which case, sure. Because we don't want to take 1 red heart of damage when we could take no red hearts of damage and protect ourselves with 3 spirit hearts instead. This is not fun. There we go. Friends till the end. Very well. The Hanged Man, I think, stands to be better for us. Because we could get something that is otherwise gated by the ability to fly, or some rocks, or a bomb, basically. We could get a lot of chests on 1 room. And now we can teleport somewhere. I mean, the Stars card is decent in the sense that it gets you into the item room for free. We're going to have 3 keys, and we're going to need, you know, some of those keys in the future to do future item rooms. But also it can get us out of a curse room, so if we find a curse room, we can use it to teleport into the item room, which is right there. Right there! Come on now. Our damage still leaves something to... Oh my goodness. Leaves something to be desired, but... Yeah, we're going... I was kind of hoping... There is a spirit heart, we should probably try for it. Ooh, I'd forgotten. Ah. Golden keys. 2 golden keys, sure. Justice. Justice card 2. Plenty of money here. So this actually turned out really well because of the fact that it does give you these sacks out of the donation machine, which is crazy. It's really good. No. Just no. I'll come back to here if we get a rune that will help or some other way of re-rolling it, but I'm not taking it. Dunce cap. It's a rate of fire upgrade, I believe. Considerable one, but it does give you the permanent Are You a Wizard effect. Oh! That tracks me so well that I had no way of getting away from it. That one as well. I'm pretty sure these things are supposed to be random, but apparently not. We're going very slowly. But I'm not trying to go slowly. It just seems to be happening. That's no good. We could use a hangman there, but like, why, I guess. I think I'm going to keep the Stars card, but just bail from this floor kind of early. Hopefully we get a deal with the devil that we can then ignore and use it to get... I hate this boss. Use it to get an angel room, probably not on the next floor though. I'm just going to hide out here. I'm going to shoot these and try and cajole it into doing that attack. Ooh, that did a lot of damage to it, so it's welcome to do that more often. Unfortunately, it does not get tempted into doing that attack just by you being next to it. Which, honestly, until literally this moment, I thought was the case. So, shows what I know, I guess. I assume that if it could hit you with that attack, it would try to. Nope. Genuinely thought I was going to get hit there, so everything went quiet. This is bad. Still no damage upgrades. We haven't really taken anything to the sisters. An HP upgrade does help. Ooh, permanent polar invincibility could get us something decent. It did. Void rage, speed and range. Well, speed is great. This would be a great time to have some HP. Slight misplay on that because obviously I intended to get more plays out of it, but I think it was because we had permanent polar rain invincibility that we managed that. Let's do this. Yes, that's a great idea. Let's not play this. There we go. Yeah, fruitcake. Fruitcake's alright. It's very scary, but it's alright. I love the rainbow tears that we get, like down our face. It's like rainbow face paint. Brilliant. We've got the effect of Godhead every so often. But we haven't actually picked up Godhead, so hopefully... Oh, hello. Hopefully we are now in Angel Room mode. Seems very unlikely, given, you know, past performance, that we have actually successfully made ourselves an Angel Run, because it seems to be impossible to intentionally get an Angel Run, but okay. Fruitcake is weird. Just saying. Like, you can't really... Oh, well done. Can't really control the tiers that you don't expect to need to control, if you see what I mean? That wasn't fun. I will absolutely take this because it will save me so much damage across the course of this run. Until we can fly, because it's going to give us Guppy because it loves us. Look at the size of our tiers now, though. It shows how much damage we've been doing. Not much at all. Guppy... Guppy's paw does not. Oh, fuck me. Guppy's paw does not not benefit at all from a battery charge. I hate carrying Queen when we have no bombs, which we do have bombs. But it's a very difficult boss to kill if you do have no bombs, because how the hell are you supposed to hit the back of it when your shots are slower than the boss moves? Bad. It's like a Zelda thing, except in Zelda you're supposed to have some sort of supply of bombs to get you through the enemy, get you through the boss fight. Ooh, very close. Probably the first time I've successfully beaten Carrion Queen. Probably one of the first times I've actually attempted Carrion Queen. We're very fast now, so that's good. Carrion Queen does not show up very often at all, which is interesting because it means you never get the opportunity to learn to fight Carrion Queen, because the only time you fight Carrion Queen, much like Dangle, the brown poop version of Dingle, you only fight it on boss rush when you're already strong enough to beat the crap out of Carrion Queen. So, I mean, I don't think I recorded the last time I played Carrion Queen. Played against Carrion Queen. So we could do with our stars card now, because I would like to go into the curse room. I think I'm probably going to not go into the curse room, because we don't have a way out. If we do get a way out, or a way in, you know, some way of not taking the damage on one of the two directions, then I will be tempted to, but I don't think my whole spirit heart is going to really be worth it. We could get said spirit heart back just by... Oh, that was terrible timing. Just by pressing the spacebar, I suppose. Kind of want it. I really wish that we were doing a lot more damage. This enemy seems to be never dying. We've got a magician card, we've got a Wheel of Fortune card. Kills we don't know. Health up, amazing. Health up! One of those was health down. I don't feel so bad about maybe just pressing this here and getting some more spirit hearts. Having an extra one or two couldn't hurt. And we've got plenty of actual HP. Even after using that. I think that was a good idea. Now we can go into the curse room. I mean, it didn't really matter whether we spent red HP or blue HP on going to the curse room. What are these tiny little shots that explode? I don't like this. They look like soy milk Ipecac shots. They just go really fast. Oh my goodness. We could use Wheel of Fortune here and sort of blow up. Use a bomb, make some space. If we're going to get one of those cards, we could use Wheel of Fortune and blow it up whilst we get said card. Okay, well, there's no point in doing that room. Yeah, let's do it. I mean, I'm not going to use Wheel of Fortune for anything else. Let's see if we can replace it with... It's a world card. That's pretty nice. And an Algis rune, which does get us into the curse room and out again quickly. So maybe I'll keep this. The world card could be useful for the next floor, but it's a lot of backtracking. I found a shop, which... Actually, we now have 15 cents, so I think I will go to the shop. We got 15 cents more as a result of... luckily happening to collect that many, rather than sort of trying to... Maybe fruitcake was not such a great idea. I seem to be incapable of piloting it and can't be trusted. Charge Baby is fine if we replace our guppy item, which I suspect we will, if we can replace it with a better guppy item vis-a-vis... I want to take the world card. The Algis rune doesn't really impress me, because we've got enough HP to go into the curse room anyway. If we can replace this guppy item with a better guppy item, i.e. guppy's head, I will be pleased to do so. This floor also took forever. We're already at 19 minutes, and we have not yet taken a single damage upgrade. We have denied a single deal with the devil, which had a guppy item in it, I would add. It's a bad trip, yeah. And I didn't take it, because we have a job to do. Ain't no use in complaining. Let's use this, see where we're going. This is very dangerous, don't do what I'm doing. Oh, you got me, partner. It's alright, my black heart will take care of you. We have plenty of keys, so there's absolutely no reason not to take this. Interesting. Good question. We should go to the item room, I think. So that's in the other direction, which is why I'm suggesting we do it. This is the direction to the boss, though. Is it worth going this fast? Can I please have some upgrades of any type? How many times... I was dodging. What the heck? How many times do we have to re-roll our stats to get decent stats and still fail to get decent stats? That thing hit me. This is hard. My brain is confused. Ooh. I don't like these tiny little shots. Is that what happens when you have an Ipecac shot without the Ipecac damage upgrade? They're just tiny. That makes some sense. How did you... I thought I dodged that well. I did not. I'm doing extremely badly and I apologise. However, I would like to add that by this time I would expect to be doing twice as much damage, at least, and have at least a rate of fire to accommodate said high damage. And in fact, apparently I can't even destroy one of these things. We have no alternative sources of damage. Our only bonus right now is little Loki, which is a very, very rare shot. It's even slower than our own rate of fire, and that's saying something. Sackhead is not coming out in the clutch for us, as we would expect it to. Maybe with something like a death card? Is that too much to ask? High Priestess. That's something. Oh, now we've got Loki's fucking horns, so now we can accidentally explode ourselves with an unexpected Ipecac shot to the face, because we're close to the wall. Why did I take it? Please. Good. I mean, any sort of upgrade at all would be brilliant. I guess this is the danger of doing these angel runs, is you just get nothing out of them. Question marks. Retrovision. Question marks. Paralysis. I'm so pleased to have been here for that. Might as well play this, because we get the permanent Polar of Invincibility plays for a while. Ooh, 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 ooh. Ah, what are you doing to me? Health up. Hooray. At least we got one more health out of it. But, you know, it doesn't do us that great a thing. It's not a boon in any particular sense of the word. How am I supposed to deal with this? Fuck it. Get rid of one of them. They all started sliding around. Oh my god. We could lose this, and I would be hard-pressed to take full responsibility for doing so. I understand that I'm in control of this, but at the same time, our rate of fire and damage have yet to be improved. Oh, for 5 minutes. Don't forget you have Guppy's paw. Probably where our HP went now I think about it. I've been replacing it. 0 for 3. It's a pretty good trade. Basically 3 free HP, 6 free hits. Let's go to the secret room. I'm getting a little bit scared. I mean, we've got Guppy's paw, which is keeping us alive. Yes, an upgrade. I'm happy to take it. I'll take two. It's a damage downgrade, but our fire rate is going way up as a result, which means we're going to get a lot more random effects from... from Fruitcake. Which means we can rely on more... It's not only the fact that I'm taking bad damage because I seem to have forgotten how to play the game, but sometimes what... Like, I seem to be badly lucky when it comes to damage that you can consider to be essentially random in the first place. Like, you know, the six shots when you think you've dodged into the right direction and you sort of have to hope. I suppose I could react better, but I seem to be incapable of doing that, as you well know. We're going to the shop, by the way. Ain't nothing you can do to stop that. Have a look in here. It is a card. It's the Emperor card, which means we can just jump straight to the boss fight if we wanted to. We could leave the curse room to do so. I don't know. I really don't know what to do in this situation. Let's see what we've got. We can use bombs, you see, to improve our lot. I hope we do this. We've taken enough damage that maybe Fanny Pack is a good idea. We can pay out with sacks, I think. Hoping for maybe more sacks from this so that I can get something decent, but I think we should use our two of diamonds and roll with our Emperor card. I'm actually not going to even bother with... This isn't going to be Envy, so I'm going to fight it. I'm not even going to bother with the Spirit Heart from that shop, because we do have plenty of them. What are you doing? Are you seeing this shit? There was no way out of that. Oh, there was. I thought there was a rock in the corner. There was no rock in that corner. Man. Thought there was no way out. There could have been no way out if I was going this way, so...
Two of spades.
See what I'm saying? Do we want to take the Emperor card or the Chariot card? The Chariot could be... Ooh. I'm going to take the Chariot card. I'm going to min-max a little bit now because we need as much assistance as we can get. I would like to be able to get to the Angel Room. Oh, fucking stop putting things in my way. I have to walk around the entire... circumference of a room all the time.
The Chariot.
Let's see if we get a payout from this jabroni here before the Chariot runs out. Ouch. Well. Come on, man. Stop holding out on me. All the way. Every single time we take a Spirit Heart, we will get permanent Polaroid invincibility. So we're going to get way more plays out of this than we would normally be... normally expect to be owed, I suppose. There's another... Is that the third one? No, it's the second one. One more of those, though, we might actually get a damage upgrade that's going to be good for us. Which I am very happy to have. Oh, yeah. It's just a fucking chain of these bastards. And then we take the Emperor card. We just fight the boss through it. It's the adversary. This is going to take all day. I thought, you know, let's just do an Eden run. We don't tend to do many of those. There's no reason not to do an Eden run since we started one. You know, don't want to waste the Eden token. Accidentally started a new Eden run at the end of the run I did with James. Continue it. What's the worst that could possibly happen? Well, the worst that could happen is you get a massive train wreck of a run in which no matter how many times you reroll your stats, you get no stat bonus. And I have just been owned... by the aforementioned... Ooh, that's pretty nice. I've just been owned by the aforementioned exploding an epic axe shot on the wall because Locust Horns is screwing us. Don't take Locust Horns when you've even got a chance of having an epic axe shot going on. So, I took some HP. That's 3 mil Spirit Hearts, basically, in the bank. I seem to have this sort of natural reaction whenever a shot's coming in. Try and hit the shot with my body rather than, you know... go in the other direction, where it's not going to hit me. Probably something I should train myself out of after, you know, 500 hours, almost literally, in this game. How many batteries are you going to give me for an item that has no benefit from batteries? Card. Two of clubs.
Two of
Take
clubs.
It. I don't really care for BOGO bombs. We could have waited on two of clubs. I didn't want to. Little haunts. Be gone. Try and stay in the middle of the room. Like, Infestation 2 should be doing amazingly for us, but it isn't. Although, now that it is, I've noticed it. But, you know, before I noticed it, it wasn't, if you see what I mean. That's very helpful. This is even more helpful, although there are no more shops, so it's not that much help. It's not as helpful as it could have been in many other situations. Wow! Okay. In case you were wondering what sequence of events just took place, an Ipecac shot exploded, it missed the enemy, and exploded on a skull, pushed the enemy towards me, which then, because it was now in line with me, attacked me, because it's the sort of enemy that chases you down when it's in line with you, causing me to go, whoa, and therefore explain what happened, because what happened was bullshit, I think we call it. That's the technical term for it. Well, we're at 30 minutes nearly, and we are only on the Necropolis 2, but at least we seem to be going a little bit faster now. More by luck than judgment, I have to be honest. What are these dodges that I'm making? It'd be super good if my holy light shots would actually hit the enemies, because those are the ones I'm relying on to do any damage. Full health. See, that's Loki's horns for you. Just don't take it in any situation where there's explosions. I think the thing I'm not realising about Loki's horns is that the shots that come out of Loki's horns are not necessarily afflicted or affected. You know, they don't have the same status effect that the shot that was fired normally at the same time had. So if you fire an Ipecac shot out of your face, Loki's horns may yet fire a non-Ipecac shot. And of course, if you fire a normal shot at your face, Loki's horns may yet fire an Ipecac shot. So you don't actually know. Probably you have a huge opportunity to react to it anyway. Whether the Locust Horn shot that's about to hit the wall is an Ipecac shot or not. Quite difficult to hit these things at the best of times, and this is the worst of times. There we go. Anything that has piercing, ooh, this fixes literally everything. Although I was expecting to see four shots hovering around it. Let's go and fight Mom. I was hoping to get a better spacebar item. Can't win them all, but I'd like to win some. I don't know what I can do with this shield. Pretty sure it defends me from bullets. So this is just going to change its status effect as we go. Where is it? It's over there. Oh. I mean, Ludovico technique is pretty fun. Oh, it keeps resetting, of course. Whenever it explodes, it will reset to your position. Which makes it very difficult to keep track of it, I suppose. Nearly done, though. So that was pretty good, actually. I guess we take the negative, because we've already got the Polaroid from the start. We're doing a little bit better now that we've got Ludovico technique, I think. I don't have to worry about where Loki's horns are, but at the same time, Ludovico technique can be quite difficult to, you know, accommodate. Where's my tear gun? It keeps jiggering around. There we go. Jiggering? Is that a thing? It just inverted itself. Now I have to dodge and figure out where my tear is and get the tear on an enemy. And the dodging thing has not been particularly well executed so far in the first place. It's probably not worth it. It could contain a guppy item, but that guppy's head. It could literally only contain guppy's head as a guppy item. I'm too fast to get in the middle of these. I don't need the money, so don't. I want my tear back. There it is. This is going to be very difficult to deal with because I don't know where these things are going to pop up. And I have to get my Ludo technique tier onto them. Which means I have to dance around, get near my tier to try and get them to be. Ooh, that was lucky. Get a little bit quiet while I concentrate. We'll get it right. This is not one of those episodes where I talk shit. This is one of those episodes where I concentrate heavily and complain. I'm surprised that that went so well. We still have 1 HP. Red. Which we can turn into 3 blue HP at a flick of a wrist. Which is currently my major strength, I think. Dagar's Curse of the Maze. Well, there's that. I think it's quite hard to use this shield with Ludo, because the shield will always point in the direction that I just moved the Ludo tier. It won't point towards the tier, it'll point in the direction of the button that I used to control the tier. Meaning it's going to be super difficult to use it for any real good. However, this may turn out to be excellent for us. We have got Card Against Humanity.
A Card Against Humanity.
Maybe I shouldn't have used it, that seems a little bit annoying. The Tower, probably a bad place to use the Tower card. We can have our Dagar's Rune back. Another Tower. Oh, I knew about it. What am I talking about? Yeah, I'm bothered by this. I mean, there's a possibility we get more sacks out of that. But there's also a possibility we get more sacks just by doing another room. So, I guess we just do the other room. There, guys, I will save. Ooh. That was a terrible dodge. I'm noticing that the curse room is... Oh, fuck. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to hit them. Somehow, some died. I guess because Loki was firing for us. I've noticed that we can get to the curse room without any bother. Ah, got stuck on stuff. I always get stuck on stuff like that because I knew in my heart of hearts if I got too close to my tier at that point that it was going to explode as soon as I got next to it, which is exactly what happened. Ah, what did I say? This is exactly what we need. Got a bad trip pill, which I don't really care for. That could become full health, but it won't. Right, let's min-max slightly. One, two... Not slightly, that'll do. This is almost certainly the direction to the boss, which is why I've been putting it off slightly. There's far too much to concentrate on right now. Oh, okay. What? Please. There we go. I'm not sure why my tear was producing further tears. Little drips. And I'm very grateful for infestation too. Because it means that any room that's any room that gives us a lot of spiders makes the next room considerably easier. Provided the spiders all do what they're supposed to. Right, that was okay. We just need to get rid of this thing, which we can actually do reasonably easily at an angle. There we go. Somehow I dodged the other one, having noticed it before it shot me. Question it not, I suppose. This is probably... Yep. Yeah, we've got a little bit faster, I suppose. It's not too bad. We are on a Mama Gurdy fight, which doesn't fill me with confidence at all, because now we need to not get stabbed by spikes, so honestly I have no idea how to predict or... react to. I don't know how long we have to react to the spikes. We did well there. We got 2 HP, which is great. I mean, we've got one just now, but we've got this Eternal Heart as well. And there's another Eternal Heart, so we've got 3 HP. I mean, yay. I don't know how many times we're going to have to get Angel Runes before the Angel Runes actually give me what we're here for. But we're not dead yet. It was Curse of the Maze, I think, so... again, no real upgrades to us. Oh, there's two of these. It's lucky that I kept moving. No real upgrades to ourselves. Got the Curse of the Maze? Yeah, I think I'll keep Dagar's for when we get in real trouble. This could be good. Friends till the end. It's not that good, but it wasn't not worth the bomb. Suddenly my Ludo tier is firing Loki shots. And now it's not again. Oh, it is sometimes. I didn't know it did that. This tier is slow. It keeps dodging around as well because fruitcake is causing it to have random worm effects, I think. Got a random charge thanks to Battery Baby, which is pretty nice. Having these flies is basically going to not only speed us up, but like, our offensive potential has gone way up all of a sudden. Our defensive potential, however, has changed naught. Battery Baby keeps, well, Charge Baby keeps stop exploding. Keeps producing these flies, these charges for our flies. We're going to be a little bit better off. This is brilliant. So we've got an AWAS rune, which I will just use. That could get us out of the hush fight. We can't get into the hush fight, so it doesn't matter. Oh. I just realised why we did so well on the Mamagurdi fight. Our Callus, in case you're wondering, gives us... I was hoping to get blood back. Our Callus makes us immune to creep and spikes. So the Mamagurdi spikes meant nothing to us over Vienna. In fact, these ones too can suck my bowls. My chocolate salty bowls. Obviously not referring to my testicles because I'm white, so chocolate salty balls could not possibly refer to those, so I must be talking about food stuff, and therefore you're the dirty one. Strength. I'm gonna keep Dagars, it could really get us out of the bind, to be honest. Is this worth it? No. It's good to have an actual item on offer though. At least you can make a decision. Yeah, fuck this noise. I'm so glad we picked up the Callus. I nearly swapped it out for something else. I seem to remember. I forget what. But I tend to like having the Callus because it means that I can be callous and just, you know, walk on stuff. Take that. I feel like these could be a secret room, but they weren't. That's okay. Trying to, you can see how infrequently it's actually... No, pulsing, the ticks of damage. You can see them. I don't think at this stage of the game we should be able to see the frequency of our ticks of damage. How did I not take damage against that red poop? Good question. How did I take damage against that thing? Well, flip a coin. I'm going this way. Oh, God help. This is a great situation to have infestation too, because half of them kill the other half as soon as the spider spawns. Brilliant. No tinted rocks, which I am looking out for. Thank you for being the scarred room where things like that happen. Okay. See, sometimes you just can't avoid it, so you have to deal with it, I guess. In case you were wondering, my tear exploded on the fire that was next to me when I walked in. So there was nothing to do. There's no way out. Stars, there's nothing for us, we'll just use these. But really want the matchstick. Said the stars, there's nothing for us, stop giving it to me. There we go. And this feels like a direction for the... boss. Well, if we get an extra life, we know how to spend it. Put Carry On Wayward Son in my head. Bow, 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 bow. Honestly? Greatest song in the world. Tenacious D, I found it. Hethro. Absolutely no use. It could give us such a benefit on the chest, you know, God willing we make it that far, to reroll substandard items or items that don't really help us in any respect into anything else. Because we're really hurting for good stuff right now. Is the secret room? It's a surprise. It's got a super greed in it. Hello. I walked into the fire because I didn't realise it was... Could re-roll this, but I don't think it's worth doing. That's a bad trip. Yeah. Health down. So one of the health upgrades that we got a long time ago was a health downgrade, and the other one was a genuine health upgrade, which is how the game works. If you have 1 HP left, then a health down is a health up. Can't concentrate on my two fingers doing two different things. For saying I play the piano. Just get in here. This way, if the if it explodes, well, it's allowed to. Because it'll be right next to me. Where's my tear at? There we go. What is it producing? It must be doing Head of the Keeper. You're actually taking damage. Will you please take damage? There we go. Probably a great time to use algae, to be honest, because I wasn't taking it down to the next floor, that's what Perthro's for. Take this to the chest. See if we get any good benefit out of this. This is such a slow run. I mean, my runs seem to take 40 minutes anyway. But this one is extra taking 40 minutes. It's superlatively taking 40 minutes. It's taking 40 minutes with a vengeance right now. These flies are definitely helping. There's no reason to be in this room. So I will not be. It's a good thing that that was just a dead end. It's nice for it to have. Again, no reason to be in this room and so many bombs. Finding dead ends like that is extremely valuable. I'm trying to dodge and also move Ludo, but I can't keep... Can't keep both of those things in my head. So, sometimes I'll move Ludo and sometimes I'll move Isaac. Also, Ludo keeps moving into weird positions. So I thought I put it in a position. I think I'm tracking an enemy. Oh, what? You saw that? I mean, very clutch movement from that enemy there to get me like that. No, not without a teleport card, which we could find. Oh, yes. Absolutely. Anything, basically, that this thing can give me is what I want. Yeah, HP is fine. Gives us a great amount of survivability. Ooh. Didn't really want a grey chest from a tinted rock, but sad onion. I think will help us. Let's find out. It can't hurt, I suspect. It's a tiers upgrade, so I think we move faster. And it should do more ticks of damage per second. We'll see. Please leave me alone. Trying to get Ludo against these motherfuckers. It's an uphill battle, I tell you. Sisyphean task. Wow. So my explosion there obviously separated them in such a way that they managed to do a pincer movement on me, even though they have no such AI programmed into them. I can't go help. Just die. Just die. If I had more flies, of course, that'd be great. Nope. No flies for me. Oh, I hate this thing. Please die faster. It's another one where it's like, how do I not take damage here? Oh, yeah. That one will actually hit me. Hooray! Got our HP back. God. I mean, what would you do here? Would you have taken Fruitcake? Would you have taken Ludo? Would we be better off without Ludo now? But, I mean, it got us this far, but now I'm thinking maybe we shouldn't have taken it and tried anyway. Because Ludo is now a liability, but earlier on, I think it was a benefit. Like, that thing died super fast, isn't it? This thing seems to have way more health. The bombs are super useful as well. I think we might have to just rely on bombs for a while. As long as we can get through the Isaac fight, we stand some chance. And I'll be honest, I'm going to be pretty pleased with myself if we manage this.
Judgment.
Nah, man. You're the wrong type. I explode you. For a sack, which contains the chariot, which I could have used to play it. We're keeping our Perthro, but what I'm going to do... It's a bit of a desperate play. He was. It's not going to do any good for us. We'll use the Hermit card to get out of here.
The Hermit.
Oh, God. Leave. And then we get this HP that's here because we have plenty of bombs. So it's the one benefit we do have is that we don't have to worry about the bombs that we use. Also, creep. So there is that. There's actually 2 HP there, so I could have just walked in and out, but whatever. I mean, I wouldn't have minded any item in there. Maybe Sin Robes? The Pact? The Mark? Abaddon? Dare I ask? You've moved. I'm not noticing when my tier moves. I'm too busy trying to not die. Good. Oh. Oh! Avoid those. We just need to get into the next phase, and then we're golden. Golden shower. Golden ticket. Golden slumbers. What the fuck was that? It was a random shot that just hit me. That's no good. It should be fine. He's been frozen. Make the most of it. Holy shit. That exploded miles away from him. He's slowed. Where you at? Yes. More flies. Get them flies in there. Whew. We can do this. Don't panic. Just calm yourself, Yago. Oh god. Why? Flies. Sort me out. Oh! I'd forgotten we got the placenta as well. We're getting regeneration in the middle of the fight. We've got a battery upgrade in the middle of the... Ow. Fight. Go for it. Can't shoot that. Oh, we did it! The world card. I don't want it. I'm keeping Perthro. And I'm taking all these flies down. You can't stop me. I'm actually going to go back and get this HP because I'm that worried. By all rights, I'm pretty sure. I don't think you would blame me for being concerned about my state of health right now. So I'll pick up this HP. There's nothing in the crawl space. But we've survived this long despite... complaints, I guess. Despite the things that I have been complaining about. Could use the chariot card to min-max more. We'll go. World card didn't really show us anything. Perthro will get us. Custom mage, great. Poop, bad. 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 I'm going to take this because it can be a benefit to us. Yes. Yes. Probably shit, so I'm gonna go with no. Maybe we can purr through it a second time, that'd be sweet. Oh, we can not worry about creep, so these motherfuckers actually don't really pose so much of a threat as they used to. I really need to keep away from them. Like, because I don't want my tear to explode in my own face, right? Okay, we're doing alright. Oh, Seraphim, that's pretty nice. You can see how much more damage we're doing now, so we have improved ourselves. I feel like this is an average run sort of thing, though. I wouldn't mind some HP, so maybe we try and kill Gluttony last, if that's possible. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, it slowed him just at the right time. Back of the net. He shoots, he scores. I'm getting excited like a football commentator. That actually filled our HP up, which was unbelievably clutch. Unbelievable, Jeff. Get in here. Kill this bastard. There we go. Dodge the, dodge all the bullshit. Get all the flies. There we go. Boss, please. I'm ready to go. We've got Bad Trip, and Bad Trip is full health when we get down to 1 HP. Which one of these is my tier? That was really confusing. In case you were wondering, I think I figured it out. The Loki's Horns tiers out that came off of my Ludo had anti-grav, but there was nothing I could do about it. So it was just hanging there in space. Until it moved itself up. Wow. Okay. Not a fan of this at all. Let's just try not to die too much, I guess. At least these things are dying fairly quickly, but I might have to throw my Bad Trip pill in here. You cannot, on the chest, blow up the doors to get out. Unfortunately. You are feared, which I noticed and accommodated by not moving. I'm just going to take all the HP. I should be min-maxing it so that we have a half-heart interval. The half-hearts are dropping anyway. And we have a Bad Trip, so... I think at this stage, my best bet is simply to try and kill everything. I'm going to take Lard, but quite fast. I want the HP. It's necessary. We have to fill it up, of course. And here's the blue baby fight. So we may actually turn this into a win, even though I was doomed from the start. And it's a very long episode, but thank you for sticking with it. I can barely cope with the fact that I've stuck with it myself. There we go. Here goes then. So we are at half-heart interval, so the best way of dealing with this is to not take damage. And if you do take damage, the best way of dealing with that is to allow yourself to continue to take damage until permanent polar invincibility kicks in. If you find yourself invincible, use Bad Trip. It'll give you full HP. Wow, what's happening? Where's my tier? It's over there. Hide behind Seraphim. Not working. Not entirely sure how I'm succeeding even remotely here. Let's get that battery. Get some more flies on the screen. The more the merrier at this stage. See, our damage is shit still. Considering that we are essentially never missing with Ludo, except when it, you know, moves. We've done it. All of our flies and spiders finally came through in the clutch. I just went completely silent trying to figure out which buttons to press. I was using this one and that one and all the other ones, but we made it work. I have to shout over the music. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that episode. I found it a chore and I will never do it again. And we didn't even get what we came for, which is the worst thing. I wonder if we can get them on the chest. That's a possibility. But anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you will join me in the next episode and I'll see you then.